In a previous video on Windows Integrated Security, we talked about making use of these PI identities along with these mappings here to map specific Windows users and Active Directory groups to the PI identity, and thereby granting access to PI. Now let's talk about how we use these identities as a way of assigning who gets to edit what PI tags, how to essentially allow or disallow editing to tags and certain attributes of tags. So let's go over to our point builder. And in our point builder, I've got three tags here. And within these tags, I'm looking at the security tab. So down here, we can see that there is a point security definition area. And that is where we assign which identities have specific types of access to editing the point attributes. And when we say point attributes, what we're talking about is when we look at a tag, it's got things like a description. And if we look at the archive setting, it's got a zero and a span, etc. And it is through this section here, point security, that we determine who has access to that and what type of access they have. We also have a section called data security. Now, data security has to do not with the attributes of the tag, but with the data that's collected and stored in that tag. So, two different sections. And the mechanism at work here is that we assign a PI identity to those tags that we would like to assign certain, you know, privileges to us, to a certain individual who maps to that identity. In other words, if I would like all the supervisors to be able to edit the attributes of this tag right here, BA temp, then what I need to do is I need to create an identity that maps, you know, to all of the supervisors when they log in. So, you know, these supervisors, through the mechanism that we described earlier, through identities, those supervisors would map to an identity called PI Supervisor. And then by assigning PI Supervisor as one of the identities associated with this particular tag, with the point security, we can determine exactly what that Windows user can do. And in this case, what we've done is we've assigned read access and write access to anybody who's in that or associated with that particular identity. So what do we really mean by that? Well, here's a PI tag called BATEMP1, right? That PI tag has associated with it in this section right here, in the point security section, it's associated that PI identity. That's something anybody can do. I can go in here if I have permission, and I can add new identities to associate with that tag. Now, adding an identity in and of itself doesn't really do anything until you specify what that identity is allowed to do. So in this case, I'm saying anybody who maps, you know, their Windows user to that identity, to that PI identity, he gets read-write access. Now that, remember, is to the point security. Now, in addition, we have this data security, and that is separate. That's the access to the data associated with the point. And I also said that anybody who maps to this PI supervisor identity here, that mapping there, or that identity, grants people read-write access. Now, if I want, I could create a PI identity for every Windows user you have. But I think what's more typical is you will find that people will create identities that look kind of like this. Yeah, here's some identities that are specific for different kind of roles within PI. Here's one called PI EI. That's for the electrical and instrumentation people, the E&I folks. Here's one for IT. Here's one for the people that are doing lab samples. Here's one for the operators. Here's one for the supervisors. So typically what you would do is, through a mapping over here, you would map individual groups of users or Active Directory groups into those specific identities. Now, we're actually not going to go into the details in this video on how to map, using these mappings, these Active Directory groups to these identities. Please go out and take a look at that video on Windows Integrated Security for that. But suffice it to say, at some point you have mapped all of your Windows users to these PI identities, so that all the Windows users all the people at your plant who log in as supervisors into Windows, they are associated with this identity called PI Sup. And then as members of that identity, they get all the privileges that that identity has in PI. If I go into Point Builder, you can see they do have some privileges. In this case, they have read-write access to both the point attributes and the data associated with this tag. And I can add them to other tags as well. So now typically, of course, you're not going to be doing this one tag at a time. You'd be doing this to tens of thousands of tags all at once using our tag configurator or something like that. But as you can see, this is the concept here. I can go ahead and add individual identities to these tags. And again, just adding the identity, that doesn't accomplish anything until you've defined what that identity gives him permission to do. In this case, the default was read access. I'm going to give him read and write access. I'll do the same thing over here. There's my supervisor identity. And now I'll give them write access to this tag as well. So we can go ahead and do that for all the tags. We can do it in bulk, of course. Now, I've been glossing over something here. I haven't really pointed out what these things are, this PyAdmin, PyAdmins, and PyWorld. Well, PyAdmin is a user, a Py user. Yes, we still do support Py users, and the only reason I would suggest using what we call Py users is if you're supporting a legacy system that was installed before we had Windows Integrated Security. See, at one point, the only mechanism we had for security were these Py users and also something called Py groups. Py admins is a Py group. We don't suggest you use that as the primary mechanism because, you know, as I just demonstrated, it is so much more powerful to be able to associate Windows logins with identities and then have those identities mapped to, you know, individual points and permissions. But we do still support these, but we don't really recommend you use those if you're not in the process of supporting a legacy system that was configured when that was the only solution. Now, the other thing I didn't point out is we also have a Py identity called Py World, and all the tags in Py by default are associated with Py World, as you can see. That's just, that's the nature of these tags. By default, if you have permission to join to the system, you know, as an identified identity, that grants you the same privileges as Py World, which, as you can see, means you get to look at the tags in Py. Now, take a look at this tag right here. Let's pretend that this baconk.1, let's pretend that that's a laboratory tag in which we would like all of the supervisors to have read-write access to both the attributes that define the point itself, things like its zero, its span, etc. And also, we want them to have access to the data collected, you know, and stored as lab results. But in addition to the supervisors, we also want lab technicians to have access, not to both the point and the data, but we want the lab technicians to have access to the data. Because sometimes when they make mistakes or discover they have to resample something, they want to go in there and fix the data, right? So they need access to that. They don't need access to this. How would we go about doing something like that? Well, the first step would be to map the supervisors and the lab technicians to two separate identities, as we've done here. And again, we're not going to get into the details of how to map them. Go out and look at that Windows Integrated Security video for that. But now, once we've got those identities, go into the Point Builder. For this tag right here, let me go ahead and add the supervisors. And I'll also add the lab technicians. As you can see, you can do more than one. There we go. Now this time, you may have noticed earlier in the video, I added supervisors, but I didn't save it. So you're going to have to save after you do this. So I'll go ahead and add them, the supervisors, to both the supervisors and the lab technician identity to both the point definition and the data. So for the supervisors, what we would like is we want them to have read-write access to the definitions of the point, and also we want the supervisors to have read-write access to the data collected by for that point. I'll go ahead and save that. For the lab technicians, they don't, in fact, need read-write access to the definition of the point. So this point security over here, this is something we can just allow them to accept the default there, which is read access. However, for the data that's associated with this point, we do want the lab technicians to have write access, so that will accomplish that. I'll go ahead and save my changes. Now, anybody who logs in as a Windows user who maps to the Py identity called PyLab, he will now, because of this, have read-write access to the data that's being stored in those lab tags. By the way, those of you who are managing a system, that predates when we integrated Windows Integrated Security into PI, you may notice that now we do have the ability to associate more than a single PI user or PI group with these objects here, these tags here. That is something brand new. So you can do any number of identities plus any number of users and groups. And here's a kind of a thing you'll figure out about users and groups. Users and groups are really just a type of identity nowadays. So you can really think of all of these as identities. I would suggest you're starting from scratch. You would go ahead and create identities at this point. There's no point in creating those legacy PI users and PI groups. Now, that's the end of the video if you understand it all. If this makes complete sense, you're good to go. Go on to the next video. However, for those of you who are a little bit lost, two things. We have an exercise coming up. Look for the video on the exercise at this. We go through this in great detail as well. And if you'd like, let's just stick around and go over a real quick analogy of how security works. Here's the analogy. Imagine that you've got a PI point, or really a PI object of any type. I've been talking about PI points, but this can be any secure PI object, like, for example, a module in the module database. Now, that PI point, imagine it's inside this little box here, and we can kind of look into the box. It's got see-through walls there, and of course, we've got more than one object. We've got hundreds, maybe thousands of these PI tags. So imagine that this list goes on and stretches on, you know, for tens of thousands of tags in this direction. All of these need to be configured with security. So how does the security work? Well, you can think of identities as though they are doors. Because see, without doors, you really can't get to that object, right? Now, when I say door E on this secure object, door E here, and then we've got door E and door S, that just means we've got multiple identities associated with that object. That would be the equivalent of, let's go back here to our point builder. That's roughly equivalent to, you know, this is the object right here, BA conk. And this would be equivalent to door S, you know, door L for lab. And these are the different doors that grant you access, or that are built into this secure object here. Now, what access are we giving people what access does this door really grant? As you can see, there's read-write access and there's read-only access. Well, going back to our analogy, imagine within these doors, you've got some doors that allow you to just kind of peek into the little window here. Okay, that's the equivalent of read access. So these doors right here are configured so that we can look. We can just kind of look through the peephole. These doors over here, the ones with the big star on them, that's read-write access. That's where we're going to grant you the ability to unlock that door, open the door, walk right in, do everything you want with that object. Okay? As you can see, that is something, that construct right there, the construct of read versus read-write, that is something that is apart from the door itself, from the identity. As you can see, this door E, that's an identity. That's got read access in this case, but in this case over here, it's got read-write access. Well, how is that managed? Well, again, that's because back here when we, let me select this right here, or actually let's go to lab. If you look at this identity, this is called PyLab. In this case, it has got read access, but when used over here with this secure object, it's got read-write access. So you can almost think of this, you know, this right here as a modifier for that door. It tells us what type of door it is. In this case, this is a door that only allows read access. This is a door that allows read-write access. Okay, so far so good, hopefully. A mapping is like a sign that you hang on the door. Remember, I said these doors allow you in. If I have access to door E, which has read-write access, I can just walk right through, I can get to the secure object. Well, how do I know whether I have access to door E or not? Well, I know because some nice person has hung a sign on that door. It says, engineers, enter here. That's the equivalent of a mapping. When you configure a mapping, it's like drawing a little sign on that identity saying, okay, everybody who's in this Active Directory group, you get access. So for the supervisors here, we've put a little sign on this door here saying, you know, this is the mapping that says supervisors, you get access to door S. And in the real world, or I should say in the PI world here, this is actually done through mappings. So when I configure a mapping, what I'm doing is saying this Windows credential is associated with this PI identity, basically hanging something on that door. And as you'll notice, you can hang, if we go back to our analogy, you can hang multiple signs on the same identity. So there's no problem at all with having multiple groups, Active Directory groups, associated with a PI identity. If we go back here, let's go ahead and take a look at our current mapping here. We can see that I can add another mapping that maps a second Windows group, Active Directory group, to this same identity. You can't map multiple Windows users, but you can map multiple groups. So if I do a new mapping, let's go out and find a different Windows Active Directory group. I'll look for all the groups that begin with the letter solution. And let's go with the lab technicians. Here's Solution Lab. That's an Active Directory group. And as you can see, I can map that to a PI identity, the same PI identity we mapped to previously. So now I've got two different Windows mappings to the same PI identity. And that's roughly equivalent to being able to hang multiple of these signs. So basically, this is the equivalent of saying, hey, everybody, anybody who sees their name on this list, you come on in through this door.